Okay, so lo and behold, just a moment ago, the memory did run out of the camera, so I had to delete a few things. I was going to be homeless within a week. I was highly stressed, very, very highly stressed about that. And so after I said, number nine, and he said, yep. And in fact, once everybody else had chosen her for himself, I once again said, number nine, she's like, duly noted, please don't stress. No problem. And then afterwards, did we need references? Like, did we need references? Oh, I don't have any references. And she said, listen, everyone, don't worry about references. Fill out the form to your best. Don't worry about the rest. Just don't worry about it. And so I did end up getting that room moved in. That was a week later. Fortnight later, I can't remember, I moved in, and it was very good. I just remember at the time as being totally grateful to have a roof over my head. I thought it was the best thing ever. And in fact, I was a bit excited about the new place, and the first night I was there, I went for a walk down the street and ended up in Newtown. I ended up at Tally that night, drinking water. Yeah. And then the people in the complex were broken people with issues in life, and that they had not resolved, and such as myself, that I was there for that particular reason as well. And broken people who were just not well, and some of them were a bit obnoxious. I interacted with very few of them, and it was all survival mode, completely survival mode. I started drinking again, not that long after I got there, I can't remember what it was, probably red wine. I think I was off to white wine at this point, maybe. Could have been red wine. I don't think I was drinking vodka. Beer and red wine, perhaps. Still hitting the town. When I would get drunk, though, I would project the future of my success and what I intended to do, and that I was in the middle of putting this book of poetry together, but also supposed to be, focusing on my feature, my screenplay, my feature film screenplay. But I suppose this stuff is embarrassing to admit, but I would project ahead to my own success in a fantasy world where I would be successful and have these successes and say, I'm taking this action toward this, I'm taking this action toward that. And I made this small movie, made a couple of short films, which I didn't get around to doing then. As a factor that came into things, I'd get very tired easily. Even back then, I'd get tired. And also the mattress provided for that, bed at Sydney was not the best. It was low grade, and so my back was being damaged. Even at Weeks Avenue at Delajill, my back dead on, and before that at Fraser Street in Marrickville, when I was there was a low. But I won't talk about that today, and even depending how this goes. These mattresses that I had were very bad for my back, extremely bad. I remember at Sydney, I had to put something under the mattress so that my back would be okay. It was a very tall room. It was a little bit bigger than this space. This is a massive garage, but it was a bit bigger than this because I got the moving carpet here and the moving carpet there. And so it was about this, the 16-foot high ceiling. I'm 6 foot, so I'm 5'11", or 12 feet. 14-foot ceiling, a very tall ceiling. I was actually quite impressed with the ceiling. And I drank And when I drank, I thought about, I'd reflected on the past, and I also thought about the future, protected to the future and the past. And I listened to a great deal of music. I had a great deal of difficulty motivating myself for the day in this place. I had feeling of doom, and my nerves were being rattled. I was going out in town, I was drinking a great deal, and it gets to a certain point where I would drink a great deal and I didn't feel satisfaction anymore. I felt a heavy melancholy, a heaviness, a sadness, the sadness which related back to the past and to things of the past, to and reflect on certain situations that I had been in, which would make me feel heavy and very sad, and very, very sad about that. And 2012 was, 2014 was when the gentrification of started, that's when the gentrification started. 2013 was probably the last year that Newtown, Enmore was the down and dirty rock and roll place that it used to be. That was the last year for it. So, drinking. Problem, but I never stopped at a few drinks because I had issues, things that I was thinking about the past, which inside me that I was sad, very sad and upset about, which is difficult to talk about and admit. It's very confrontational, very confrontational. I get heavy about it as well, obviously. I was in complete survival mode until 2012, total complete survival mode, and was looking ahead to something better and different for myself. I'm going to wrap it up in a couple of minutes, we'll see how this went. I had no idea what, I knew what I was going to talk about, as in how long I was going to go for. Once I'm comfortable in front of the camera, it's going to keep going. And this light today, I hope this is working because it's, I brought a new charger down. I put a new one in, which is in the charger, so I took the old one out. They last about 12 hours, roughly, filming. They're pretty good. Yeah. It was the old world. It was the old world. And I suppose it's what you make of things, and it's the perspective that you have on things. It's a perspective. And I have written about this. And I've written about this. I've talked about it. And what am I looking for? Truth. An understanding within myself, truth. I get an anger toward the world as it is presently. Very how things are going. I can speak more on that later. This is just a. I don't know how this went. I just thought I would try this, and if it didn't work, so be it. I'm probably going to send it to you, I think, maybe, and see what you think. I just thought it might be interesting just to film, and then if you haven't seen me, you know what I look like. And I just thought this might be alright, but this might go. Something to try. gets warmer in here now with these blankets up. Okay, so I'm going to leave this here. I could probably keep on talking. I'm going to leave this here and see how this paints. So baby, this is from me to you. Hello. I wanted to share a few words and just focus on 2012 because it came up. And talk again soon. Maybe this worked. And have a good afternoon. Have a good afternoon and evening.